Hello, today I want to show you a stereo system that I've built from components purchased strictly at thrift stores. It took a long time to collect all this stuff. I've collected lots of stuff from thrift stores in the past, but I wanted to put together an all Technics system. So what I have here, first of all, I'm going to start from the ground up because I want to save the best for last, is I have a Technics audio cabinet in very good condition. It holds records on the bottom. And the three components that I purchased in the top. It's got a glass door, closes nicely, and there we go. And I got that for $12 at a thrift store. The next thing I'll show you is the CD changer. Works perfectly. Everything works. The shuffle, all parts of it work. And I got that for $5. Directly above that, another $5 item is this Technics cassette deck recorder, and I've tried all functions on this, and this as well works just like new. Above that, Technics quartz synthesizer receiver, and it has a graphic equalizer. It's not a high powered amp, but it's got good sound, and again, everything on this works. I picked that up for only $8. The only real defects, if you want to call them defects at all, are some of these components, or actually all three of these components, do have some small marks on the top. But the way they're situated in the cabinet, you don't even know that they're there. The faces of these units are still in really, really good condition. Also, I got at the thrift store a pair of JBL speakers. They cost me $5 each. One over here and one over here. The grills don't come off, so I really can't show you the drivers inside. But I did take them apart from the back to make sure that they were good, and they are still solid. All the foam around the speakers is still in great shape. And I got these for $10. The speaker stands are really the only thing that I didn't purchase at a thrift store. I've had them for quite some time. And the thing I'm most proud of is this purchase here. It's a Technics SL10 turntable. This machine, when it came out in the 80s, retailed for approximately $800. On eBay, you can purchase these record players from anywhere between $250 and $400. I purchased this one for a mere $25 at a thrift store. At the time I purchased it, the platter would spin, but the tone arm would not move at all. And in this unit, the tone arm is located in the lid. And what I found after taking it apart was that there's two separate motors that work this turntable, one for the platter and one for the arm. And what had happened, I guess, over the course of time, is the motor that drove the arm seized up. So with a little bit of compressed air and WD-40, I got this thing working beautifully. It runs just like it would if it was brand new. And it has been running now for the past year. So I've had this now for a year, and it's been running great. I wanted to demonstrate this just to show you how it sounds. And I'm using a white vinyl record just to so you can see a little bit better inside the turntable.
People see us everywhere. They think you really care. But myself, I can't deceive. I know it's only make believe. My one and only friend, is that someday you can. My hopes, my dreams come true. My one and only you. No one will ever know how much I love you so. My only prayer will be someday you care for me, but it's only me.
There, I'm going to turn the camera off for just a second because I want to show you something else that's quite amazing. Okay, what I'm going to show you now is something that makes these machines really incredible. The tone arm balancing system basically works when the turntable is laying flat or on its side. So I'm going to show you how this record player operates, playing on its side. So I'll hit the start button.
People see us everywhere. They think you really care. But myself, I can't deceive. I know it's only make-believe. My one and only friend, is that someday you can. My hopes, my dreams come true. My one and only you. No one will ever know how much I love you so.
So there you have it. Like I said, I purchased that turntable for $25. It did require some work to get it going again. But even one that's broken, people on eBay will buy it for parts for around $100. So I knew it was worth more than $25, even broken. But luckily, I did get it working. And like I say, you can buy these turntables on eBay between $250 and $400. And as you can see, I've managed to put together an entire Technique system for under $80, including that turntable. So this is just goes to show you what you can do if you're in a thrift store. Look around, check out the electronics. It'll take a while. It'll take some time to get stuff together. But if you're looking for a stereo system at a good price, that's one place to look. Thanks for watching.